Hi guys, so thank you for tuning in to my next little journey that my body's going through. I guess it's been through quite a bit over the last couple of years. So at the moment I'm 16 months postpartum. In a couple of days time I am going in for my surgery. So I'm going to get my boobs redone. I was deciding whether or not to get my implants completely taken out or to get smaller ones. So prior to having kids, I was over the size of my boobs. I just wanted smaller. I could never fit into any bikinis that I bought in online. I'd always have issues with crop tops and things like that. And it was just really getting to me. The reason why I got a bigger implant, so I got 450cc to begin with, is because I naturally had bigger boobs before I started competing. So I had an E cup, and all the dieting and everything obviously changed that. And in order for me to avoid to getting a lift, I had to go a bigger implant. So now post children, I'm ready to have a smaller implant. I'm not completely ready to have nothing at all. I went from a G cup, and after speaking with my surgeon, who's Dr. Guy Watts, in our first consult, even he agreed that I wouldn't fully be ready to have nothing whatsoever. I looked at photos pre my last surgery that I got done in Thailand, and I know that there was a reason why I got them done in the first place. We discussed the option of having the implants completely removed, doing some fat grafting, but fat is really unreliable. You're not necessarily going to get what you want. Like, I'd be happy if I got a C cup, but we just don't really know if that would be possible. Obviously, it's not going to sit nice as what it will with an implant as well. So we're going between he's got 300 and 340cc, so he's just going to kind of see. I said that I would prefer to be a C, borderline D. I don't really want to be a D cup or anything beyond that. So I definitely want to be a little bit smaller, but then keeping in mind that I do have quite big shoulders and I do train them a lot, so I don't want to be like, you know, feeling a little bit masculine with that. I'm just not too sure. Like, I see a lot of females that have like no boobs and everything, and I think it looks great with them, but I'm not as curvaceous, I guess. So we'll just kind of see. I'm sure that we'll get it right. I'm really excited. So it's not just a straight swap implant. I have to get a lift. We're actually creating a double internal bra as well to lift me up, because naturally my boobs sit lower on my chest wall, so we need to increase, like, create that double internal bra sort of thing to push them up higher. So it's going to feel weird to begin with, because I'm going to have boobs like up here, but I'm excited to be able to chuck on a top without a bra, a dress without a bra. You know, I've worked so hard in between Tarek and Azra and post Azra to get my body to an amazing place where I'm really happy and just proud of myself from getting where I am. So I just feel like this is going to kind of complement. And you know, even though I'm getting a bit older, I will be 38 this year. So I kind of thought, oh, you know, like, I'm going to have to get them done in 10 to 15 years time again. Is it time just to get them out? But I feel like I've still got like quite a few years in me left to, you know, enjoy my body. And I feel like this is a reward for me as well. So I'm really excited. I've got my mum. She's going to be here with me next week, so I have someone to help look after the kids, because I have to have 12 weeks off with this surgery, just because it's poses a high risk creating that double internal bra. So I really need to make sure that I have time off to recover. Pretty hard when you got two kids. So I was kind of said to Guy Watts, you know, let's be realistic here. I will probably have to pick up my kids, but I've got my mum home with me the next week, my husband the 2 weeks after. So I've got 3 weeks where I definitely won't be picking up the kids, because they can do it. So that will definitely help. Post my last surgery, like week two, I was back in the gym training legs. He has told me to get in my mind that it's probably going to be 6 weeks that I can do anything at all besides walking. Obviously we can assess that with how I go in terms of my recovery and stuff, but I think that he just knows the type of person that I am. So I'm going to struggle a little bit, because I'm just like really happy with where my body's at. I just took some photos and stuff and a video just to kind of remind myself. But I also reminded myself that my first surgery, 12 weeks after that, I won my pro card. So it is totally possible to get back to that. So, you know, I think how many months it was. So I got them done in November, December, January. Well, 4 months, 3 to 4 months afterwards I did. So, you know, considering that I didn't train upper body for 8 weeks and then I went and did that, like, I just got to remind myself that it's not like having kids and being pregnant for 9 months, not being able to train hard, that, you know, hopefully I'll get back to a good position quite quickly. And let's face it, I've got the rest of my life to kind of train as well. So I'm just going to be super tight with my nutrition. I have been kind of eating whatever the hell I want since Christmas. I haven't really been strict to myself or tracking. I've probably been averaging 1800 to 2000 calories a day. No cardio. I maybe do a walk once a week with my friend Courtney. It's just our little thing to get out and do a walk on the coast. And then I've just been weight training like 4 times a week. The last month I've been training my butt like 4 days a week. So I just wanted to get in as much time as possible with my training. But yeah, I feel like I'm in a really good position. I'm super excited about this surgery. I am really happy with my choice in doctor. I felt completely at ease straight away with Dr. Guy Watts. The first appointment that I had, he just listened to me, and you know, I can talk. He listened to everything that I had to say and really took it in and took it on board. And then afterwards he explained, but also had a conversation with me. He didn't just tell me what was going to happen. And that is really good, because I've heard some horror stories and he really listened to me, which I thought was really important. So I know that I'm in good hands. I've got, you know, 3 more sleeves until surgery. I'm excited, but I'm going to let you guys know everything of how I go recovery wise. I'm going to put some photos and videos in with this video so you guys can see the results for yourself. It's pretty full on, in your face, probably the most raw that I've ever been showing these kind of things. But I just really hope that you guys get something out of it, you know. I definitely contemplating and having the explant and everything, but I've never had an issue with implants, and I do understand that people do. But for myself, I didn't. So I'm going to definitely have implants again, and it's just kind of my decision. So always base things, I guess, on your health, how you feel. You know, it's a full mental thing as well. So it's about your emotional, mental health, as well as physical. So you've got to take all those things into account, and I'm really happy with my decision, and I'm excited to show you guys the results. So thank you. Here's me signing out, nervous, anxious, but excited for this surgery in a couple of days time. Thanks guys. So it is super early, 6 a.m. I have checked in to my recovery room. Got a little view there of Mounts Bay. It's kind of cute. Yes, so I am just waiting for the nurses to come. Gonna get gowned up and get ready to go down to theater, because my surgery is at 7:30. I am first on the rank. So still nervous, really nervous. Was hard leaving the kids this morning. Wanted to go in the rooms, but also didn't want to wake them up, so I managed to peer my head into Azra's room. But I'm going to be fine, and like they tell me, it'll be over in a flash for me. So here we go. Hey guys, so I'm out of surgery. I think it's been an hour and a half, and I'm actually in shock and disbelief of how good I feel right now. So I can say that it has been a million times better experience than the op that I had. So just to give you a bit of insight, I can't remember if I touched on it before in my first video, but when I woke up in Thailand, I got woken up on the operating table, told that I need to breathe, and could feel the tube coming out of my mouth. It's actually so clear, the whole post-op thing. And then they removed me from the gurney onto the hospital bed, and it was painful. So I woke up in recovery. I feel a little bit tight in my chest. It's like nothing that I can't handle.
But that is it. Like, there is like no pain or anything at the moment, keeping in mind I'm on the good stuff, so hopefully it's a sign of how I will feel for the rest of my recovery. But I'm feeling really good. I mean, the fact that I'm doing this video actually shows a lot. So yes, I would just like to say thank you to everyone who's messaged me. I've not had messages from all my closest friends, but a lot of people messaging me and wishing me good luck, and it does really mean a lot. I was in surgery for 5 hours, so a little bit longer. I know that he had to do quite a bit of work to fix the current implants and what had happened there, but I'm excited to see the results, and I will keep you guys updated on everything. Yes, I think that's all I have to say right now, probably forgetting stuff, but I saw Dr. Guy Watts before I went into surgery, and he was actually really good and calmed me straight away, which was nice. Put his hand on my shoulder and reassured me that everything was okay, so I can't thank him enough for making me feel as good as what he did, and that's exactly the reason I went to him. So yes, I will keep you guys updated on recovery, but so well, so good, like incredibly good in comparison to what I was expecting. So thanks guys, I'll keep you updated.
Hi guys. Okay, so tomorrow I will be 2 weeks post-surgery. It's taken me a little longer than I would have liked to actually do this video. I guess it's just been recovery, mum life and all the rest of it as well, and keeping on top of my work. So yes, it's taken me a little bit of time to get here. So I do apologize, because I know a lot of people have been kind of waiting for me just to release this video to find out what I got done. So yes, 2 weeks post-surgery, recovery went so friggin' well. I had a bit of a struggle on the Sunday when I got home out of hospital, but I don't think it was so much the surgery itself and the pain, but it was more the stress of being around with the kids and not being able to do anything. And the kids had been kind of at home all day Saturday whilst I was at hospital, and then it was like a day two of being kind of stuck at home. So I think that our kind of pain was maybe amplified, and I was only taking Panadol that day. I had to wait to the following day to have Nurofen. I do not respond very well to pain meds, like heavy stuff. I know that I can't take it, so I literally have Panadol and Nurofen and that's it. The night when I left hospital, I didn't actually leave until probably 10:30 at night, because they said, oh, you can stay up to 12 and then, you know, you don't get charged extra or anything for the hospital stay, because it was just day surgery. So I stayed till like 10 o'clock at night because I was feeling so tired. I was just exhausted. I was really tired from the surgery, and same like a few days after. It wasn't until the Wednesday where I kind of felt a little bit better again. So I stayed there for as long as I could. And then I had some more painkillers, and I got up and I felt really dizzy, and I was actually sick because I can't handle the heavy stuff. I'm very much a lightweight. So I've just had Panadol and Nurofen, that's it. And by 1 week I had, like, I think it was the Sunday, so it would have been 8 days, I was actually fine to stop taking pain meds. So it just kind of shows how quickly your body recovers. I was so impressed. Like, you know, you asked me the day after surgery and stuff, I was a bit like, oh my gosh, like, you know, just trying to get my head around it all. But yeah, your body recovers so quickly. It's amazing how well that it can do that. But yeah, so everything was good by day four. I had gone to the shops with mom. I was walking around the shops. It was a little bit of struggle, and I was a bit hunched over from the surgery still. I didn't feel like I could really pull my shoulders back, whereas now I can a little bit. So it was a little bit awkward, and I had to stop a bit, but I was fine to kind of, you know, get out and get my steps in. I've done now 3 coastal walks. So I've had a few days where I've done like 12K steps, but otherwise I've just been kind of relaxing. I saw Guy for, Dr. Watts, sorry, for our 2 week checkup on Wednesday, and he said that he's really, really happy with everything. I just have to wear like a second bra now. So keep in mind, this is kind of like a makeshift thing that we've done because we've had to use two bras. So I've got the normal bra underneath, and then this one here is a separating bar. I've got my hair tie here and also another one down here because we don't want to separate my cleavage. I can't sew. So it's kind of like taped up, and then I put those two things there because it's just like pushing out my boobs. But the reason why I've got this second one is because it's extra support here. So we just want to make sure that we keep everything as north as possible, because you did that double internal bra, like there is a higher risk that something could happen. So we've got to make sure that we keep everything up. I've got to continue to not lift the kids. It's going to be a little bit hard to navigate around because my husband has to go back to work. So I'm just doing that as less as possible. I've managed to teach Azra to get up and down the high chair on her own. So she's doing really well, but it's just getting in and out of the cot and then putting her in the car. So my little brother has conveniently hurt himself again, and he's going to be around a little bit. So I might call on him for help getting Azra in and out of the car to go to daycare. But yeah, otherwise everything is going really good recovery wise. I did have some issues with my digestion, and I blame myself hugely for this part because I could have made things a lot better, and it was really silly of me because it's all things that I know. So, you know, obviously your body does have a reaction when you have like all of the strong medication and stuff to go under and everything to do with the surgery, and it can affect your digestion. I could have made things a lot better by taking my probiotics straight away, which I didn't do. Also making sure that I was drinking enough water and having enough fiber in my diet. And I just made like a whole heap of chicken and rice. I wasn't eating the meals that I had given to me, and I was just eating that. So I wasn't really getting that much fiber. I wasn't eating a hell of a lot, and I just wasn't drinking enough water. I guess because I was just like sitting in one spot all the time, and it was just a bit hard and too much to just like pull the water up to myself or to get up and do things. I just was being really lazy, so I could have made things a lot better. So if you get having that surgery, please make sure you do those things first. And I really should have known better, but since then it's kind of turned around a little bit. Well, a lot, I should say. My stomach is quite bloated, and it's weird because it's, beside being pregnant, the first time that my stomach has stuck out further than my boobs. So that's a little bit to get used to, but hopefully in a week's time, it'll all go down and settle again. It is getting better and better every day. And yeah, so that was kind of, that became more annoying than the actual pain itself from the surgery. But pain-wise, everything has been really good. I'm really happy so far with recovery-wise and everything like that. I have taken some photos to show you guys the comparison of like literally a couple of days before surgery as to what it looked like a week and a half post it would have been. So I will make sure I include those in this video. But yeah, all in all, like I'm really happy so far with how recovery has gone. I remember waking up in hospital and literally thinking, oh my gosh, I would pay him double for that experience because it was so good. So my experience in Thailand was so different to this. It was nice to just wake up in recovery. Dr. Watts was amazing and so comforting before I went into surgery, reassuring me. I did not feel anxious. I was really worried that I'd have to get stuff to calm myself down, but I wasn't anxious at all. The anaesthetist as well was really good and make sure that I was calm and stuff as well, just by his mannerisms, like nothing that he gave to me. Like, so it was a really good experience in that way and totally worth it. I have had a lot of people that have asked me a few questions. Oh, one of the answers, obviously I haven't covered this, is we ended up doing 340 cc. So we were going to do either 300 or 340, but then when he puts the 300 in, he said there's just so much room still, so we went with the 340, which I'm really happy with. So I'm glad about that, like size wise and everything. I'm really happy. I have had a lot of people message me and they're kind of asking me, you know, how much my surgery cost and everything like that. You know, I obviously, everyone's surgery is going to be so different. Mine was a really complicated surgery. Like I actually had quite a lot of things done. I had to have the implant removed and the double internal bra, and I had fat grafting done as well. So there was a lot involved with my surgery. So it's all going to come down to exactly what you need to do. And really, okay, so when I made my appointment for my consultation with Dr. Watts, I actually tentatively booked in my surgery date as well. Because for me, obviously money is a factor, but it wasn't like the be all and end all of me. Like, I knew that I wanted him to do my surgery because the feedback that I got from people and all the great things I heard from him, but also his work. So it wasn't a question for me as to how much it costs. So when people are like asking me, you know, how much does it cost? Like, I don't work for him, so I can't tell you, oh, you know, like if they've got a price from a different surgeon, that seems really expensive, because it just depends on what you need done. Like, you know, that's all going to factor into things. But really, I think that everyone is going to be really comparative when it comes to pricing. You'll find surgeons are, and you've just got to remember what you're kind of paying for. Like, it's the same thing with personal training. You know, I have a few people that will contact me, and when the first thing they ask me is how much I charge per session, I know that they're not going to come to me for as a client, because I haven't been doing PT for 2 seconds, and I'm not going to charge you $50 for a session or $40. Like, that's just not what I'm going to do. So you've got to remember that if you want something good, like, you pay for it. Okay, so it's all about the quality of things. So if, you know, you, and one thing that Dr. Watts said in our consult was, if you want, you can, they do finance, but he actually sits there in the consult and tells you, if you need to get finance to get your any surgery done, you probably shouldn't get it done. So, you know, obviously, I understand that price is a huge factor for people, and it's different to everyone. This is going to cost you money. So you've just got to kind of keep that in mind. And if, you know, it's something that's out of your reach, then you probably shouldn't be doing it. Do you know what I mean? So just kind of keep that in mind when it comes to things like that. So that's a huge question that I was asked all the time, was how much my surgery cost. And you know, I'll say to people, if they recommend, like, they tell me how much someone else, most of the time it's, my answer is, that sounds pretty reasonable. But you know, I am not a plastic surgeon, so I can't really tell you how much things should cost you. But if you want a good job, like, money shouldn't really be the be all and end all for you. You know, that shouldn't be where you kind of draw the line. And like I said, when I woke up, I was like, I would literally pay him double, because the experience that I had was amazing, you know. And I don't think you can put a price on being looked after really well and getting a good result. So that is all from me. I will probably do small updates and stuff through my Instagram and that. So just keep an eye on my social media, and I will continue to update you guys that way. I might do a video later on down the track if people ask me lots of questions and, you know, they want to see how they look in 6 weeks' time, because it's going to totally change. It's going to change up to a year's time of how my implants and stuff look. But I'm really happy. If you are looking for a surgeon in Perth, I couldn't recommend Dr. Guy Watts like anymore. Like, I don't think I could express in this video of how highly I do recommend him, because he was great and the experience was really good. Really happy with my decision, and that, you know, everything went so well. So thank you guys so much for tuning in and listening to being a part of this journey, this new journey that I went on. It's been great, and I mean, I can't wait to get back into training. You know, I've only got 10 more weeks until I'll be back in the gym. Bye bye gains, but that's okay. It'll definitely be 6 weeks of until I can do anything, even lower body. So 4 more weeks left for that, and you know, I'm just going to continue to do walks and try to eat in a deficit so I don't put on any weight. See how we go. But thank you so much, guys, for listening to me ramble. I appreciate you. Bye.